Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play Dragon's Dogma Dark Arisen. So in the last video, or the last few videos, there's quests here. We've been doing kind of some some side quests that are generally important to my playing of the game, or important to the plot. Madeline has a request for us to escort her to Bloodwater Beach. That's interesting. I'm not going to do that right now. So, for example, we talked to Fornival. We helped him with his trial. That was a story critical quest. But then afterwards, he asked us to babysit his daughter for a day. So we wandered around town and did all sorts of stuff with her. And that was not a story critical quest. Like, not super, super, super important or anything like that. But we did get the golden idol. And the golden idol that we got for doing that, we turned in to Madeline, the shopkeeper. And she will have a much improved inventory later on when we come visit her in the future. So similarly, we also went and hunted a cyclops out in the goblin-infested mines. I was just checking to see if there were any items there. So we went and hunted a cyclops so that we could get the silver idol, and then we gave that silver idol to Caxton the Armor, who's also here in town, and he will also have a better inventory at some point in the future. So I'm just going to kind of continue these sorts of side quests. And actually, I want to go through the quests that I have. If I can find the right menu. Just kind of a quick recap. So, you know, feel free to skip ahead a minute or two if you don't care about the quests I have available to me right now. But King Bayleaves, we can go kill some Sulfursaurians. That's easy. We've encountered those before. We know where they're at. Stout Undead, similar. Those are in the vicinity of the Abbey. We can hunt for them. Those are the fat guys that explode phantasms. So this is an interesting little side quest here that is going to be important to kind of the story and the goings-on of the game. Following the thread of Salvation. Salvation is having some sort of secret meetings, and we think that they might be involved in the recent skeleton uprising. There's lots of skeleton sightings in the area. We need to hunt the Griffin. This is actually our next story mission. This is very critical to the story here. Griffin's been harassing caravans coming to and from the town, so we are going to meet up with some mercenaries who have a plan to try to deal with it. Let's see. One of Fidel, the Chamberlain, he believes that one of the armies stationed at an outpost is potentially going to commit treason and perform some sort of uprising, maybe march in the capital or something. I don't know. He's very worried about it, and he wrote all of his information down and was going to give it to the Duke, but then he lost the letter. We're actually going to do this quest next. It was taken by a flying creature, so probably like some harpies or something. There's a bunch of harpies up north, so we're going to go check up there. Kept sour ambrosial meat. We need 5 of those. That's just going to take time. It's going to be fairly tedious to acquire those. Slay 29 oxen. We need to kill, you know, 12 more. So we're making decent progress there. We need to kill a bunch more crows, boars, skeleton magi, 2 more chimeras, more snakes, golems. We haven't even found any golems. Don't really know what those are. But 75,000 gold if we can kill 3 of them. We need to kill 23 more undead warriors. Again, we know where those are around the abbey at night. Phantasms again. Still need to find a bunch of those. We have 2 quests for phantasms now, so we can probably knock out both of those at the same time. 20 seeker tokens. Those are just tedious. We just need to hunt for them. They're in a few areas, and they respawn every couple of days. Kept giant fish. We have like 8 giant fish or something like that. Not quite 10, and not enough airtight flasks to keep them. And then another King Bayerb. So our quests are kind of stacking up. We have a lot of very similar, like 2 quests involving getting King Bayleaves and 2 quests involving hunting phantasms and that sort of thing. But these, the monster hunt quests and the find 20 of these items quests and those sorts of things, not super concerned about right now. Those are like from the notice boards. Also, let's look at where we're at. The ones that I care about right now is, yeah, so we're going to head in that general vicinity there and see if we can find a flying creature in what is apparently known as the Cursewood, according to the map. And I'm going to go the long way. We're going to walk over there. We could take a port crystal, we'll warp up to the healing spring there, and then head across, but, you know, good to get out and get some exercise every now and then. Also, we can pick some more flowers and things like that. Yeah, so I'm going to focus on these quests for specific NPCs first. Those seem...
Seems we're well downstream.
maybe a bit more important to me. The other ones will just kind of happen when they happen. Like, I'm not too worried about hunting for phantasms or undead or anything like that. We'll find them. Fortunately, the Saurian jumped there, so I didn't hit him with my ice attack. We need but seven of the tails. Oh, and again, just poor timing. Very unfortunate. Oh well. Lucy's meteor shower took care of him. No problem. Yeah, so let's see. I'm running around here as a sorcerer, the advanced version of a mage. Mostly to gain the increased magic attack, so I can do extra damage with magical weapons and magical spells. And I will gain that as we level up as this class. In, like, I gain much more magic offense power when I level up as this class than any other, so that's a very good thing. Because I am planning on making use of, like, magical items and maybe other magical classes later on in the game. We're still early on. We're still relatively low level. I know we're, what, like, level 35 or something like that? 36. Close. It was a good guess. But this is still, you know, very early on in the game. You can get to massive, very high levels later on. Kind of towards the end game, and even, you know, going into, like, New Game Plus and that sort of thing. But I, you know, still very much in a growth phase. It's very important to kind of get a good foundation, and I am planning on playing, you know, later on when we get to some of the tougher end game sort of stuff, like when we're going after the actual dragon himself and those sorts of things. There are a few specific classes that I'm going to want to be playing as, and I'm going to be making heavy use of magic. And that is going to be very important. So I will give you a hint. It's not the sorcerer, and it's not the mage. It's going to be some of the hybrid classes that I'm interested in. And so getting this extra magic and getting like some extra stamina and stuff so I can cast spells or climb monsters, that sort of thing, also going to be very, very important. So that's kind of why I've been flopping around between all these different classes. And then the warrior, he had a couple of good skills that I wanted to acquire, a couple of good augments. But that was more just to show it off than anything else. So here's some Sulfur Saurians already, which we do have a quest to kill, what, 10 of these? So there's a good chance that we're going to resolve that quest just right here and now. Sulfur Saurians are the ones that can turn invisible. They're like chameleon-y, I guess. I missed the one who was jumping through the air, I believe, but I hit a bunch of others. Yeah, this is pretty fantastic. That giant icicle spike that I keep hitting them with has a pretty large area that it hits in. And these Sulfur Saurians are quite weak to the fire. There's also some hobgoblins, it looks like, kind of off and to the right a little bit. Its tail is most likely its weakness. Far stronger than a common goblin. Awesome. Alright, so let's grab like some items, Saurian tails and those sorts of things. Was there another one? Nope. Okay. Just see what we can loot from these Saurian corpses here. Looks like it wasn't quite 10. It was probably, what, like 4 or 5, something like that. Let's deal with goblins now. Although, yeah, it sounds like there are some more Saurians around here. Oh man, that attack is just fantastic. Cool. And then I hear some more Saurian grunting, so it's probably going to be a few more around here. Let's see if we can just finish off all 10 of them right here, because that would be very nice. I don't think it's very likely to happen. Also, I don't know that these Saurians are actually weak to ice. So my icicle spike is not freezing them or anything like it does the normal Saurians. They might be. I don't know. Maybe my spell is just not strong enough. Rift Crystal, 400 Rift Points, that's awesome. We ought to equip ourselves to suit our objectives. Yeah, I don't really see or hear any more Saurians, that's unfortunate. Oh, we still made good progress towards one of our little side quests. Aha! There you are. Oh. Okay, so it looks like these Sulfur Saurians are weak to fire. Like, quite weak to fire, because I did a lot of damage with that fireball spell. There we go. Yeah, look at that, and that's 10. That's exciting. I hadn't really intended to accomplish that quest, but I am more than happy with that. Well, let's kill some of these goblins over here, just because why not? They're in my way. They're easy to kill. Easy discipline. Discipline is critical for learning skills, especially since I keep bouncing back and forth between all these different classes. So, anything to get some extra discipline and maybe work on increasing my rank as a sorcerer, because it looks like Lucy's rank just went up. Alright. So that wasn't bad. Just kind of poking around here to see if there's any loot that the goblins may have left behind. Doesn't look like there is. Oh, there is a glowy butterfly flower. Jasper Blossom, that's exciting. Cool, so yeah, now it's more or less just a matter of making a beeline up to the north wall here. Oh, I'd rather not fight any more Sulfur Saurians. Although I think maybe I do have some need for like striped saurian skins or yellow poison sacks, the two items that you can get, or two of the items that you can get from these saurians here, these sulfur saurians. I think I might need a few of those for upgrading armor or weapons. Although I'm not positive I still need those. That might have been earlier. So yeah, I guess I am going to fight these guys after all. I love how sometimes you can, like, scare them off and watch them, like, scurrying away. It's funny the way the Saurians move. I really like it. Really neat little animation when they drop down on all fours and just, like, scamper away. Okie dokie. We are approaching the north wall here. There's some more Sulfur Saurians. Holy moly, these things are all over the place. Let's see if we can not fight more of them. More for the sake of saving time than anything else at this point. Looks like there's going to be a bunch of bandits around here. That's unfortunate. I'll grab some mushrooms here. These are fantastic for stamina recovery. And I do like to sprint until I can't sprint anymore. Alright, let's see what we can do to some of these. Can I hit two of them? Yeah, I got them both. That's exciting. And we killed the mage there. Wasn't too bad. Nice. And that one's almost done. There we go. Yeah, again, not terribly happy with Zeus. Let's take a look at him real quick. I believe Zeus is a guardian. Yeah, guardian is his primary inclination, so he will stay very, very, very close to me. So good if, like, an enemy charges at me and gets, like, right up in my face. That will maybe get him to fight them off or something. But otherwise, he's kind of not the most helpful in battle, which is unfortunate. Okie dokie. So now it's just a matter of looking through this area for a backpack with a letter in it. And it looks like we might have just found it. Thank you, game cutscene. Oh, are you kidding me? Is that a dragon?
I've learned what to.
Are you kidding me? Cover the stolen dispatch. Find and retrieve the letter that the monsters had from the monsters that snatched it. Where does the game want us to go? Up into like a cave of some sort, it looks like?
You in this quest.
Which is pretty much directly behind me.
I'll take that.
So I guess we're gonna try to do that. It's up there. Not like far, just up. So we're gonna work our way upwards. Let's see how this goes. This might be a bad idea.
Bandits arisen.
Dang it. I was hoping we could avoid those bandits there.
Tis a threatening
be healed. I'll hear all our wounded.
The attack in quick succession. The ranged ones are mine.
There we go. Finish that one off. There we go.
Did it. Great.
It'll take more than that.
All right, that wasn't too bad. There were only three of them, so that is fine. So let's head over here and see if we can find what that cave is or whatever that is. Sorcerer? What? Where? Oh, they're up on that rock there. All right, well, let's hope that we can avoid that fight. The more of these fights that I can avoid... Oh, dang it. I was going to say, the more of these that I can avoid, the better, because then we could get done with this quest faster.
I will protect you, Arisen. Counter after they strike.
Wait for an opening. We have triumph.
That was hardly
okay.
A warm-up.
Again, there were only two, so that's fine. Now, let's see what we have over here. Yeah, so it looks like some sort of cave that we're going to be going into.
The animals of the field. Cave entrance.
Red wine, that's exciting. Nice, classy drink. Okay, so I guess we're gonna just go check out this cave. Whatever it is. Mines, ruins, something. The Soulflayer Canyon. That's a nice, exciting,
seems
cheerful name.
It'll be easier going searching this area now.
Oh, I believe I do actually remember what's in here. This is
Beetle's pack was stolen by the likes of those
Yeah, so I'm gonna go ahead and equip a lantern just so we can see a bit better in here. Yep, and so there's snow harpies in here, which I'm not going to really do much damage to because I have an ice staff. Although if Lucy could hit them with meteors or something, that would be fantastic.
I will protect you.
Glacial opinion? Ah, cutscene. Yeah, so whatever it is that had our... that flew off with the pack there... It is down there, and there's a bunch of letters and things scattered across the ground, so it's tearing that pack apart. And that is a gargoyle, I believe, which we have not fought any of yet in this game. So that's exciting. It's new.
That was hardly a warm-up.
And also we get to explore a new area, so that's also a bit exciting.
What's this?
Boy, it'd be nice if I could hit those things with fire or something. Alright, let's do lightning.
Strike, let the harpy sing!
So it put my pawn here to sleep, so I'm going to go ahead and wake her up. Oh, excuse me. Well, I can hit that one at least. And kill that one. Oh, and there's like a Cyclops up there, kind of to the left. We'll take a look after we kill that Harpy. Yeah, Cyclops kind of up there above my character's head, you can see on that bridge. Where's that Harpy feather?
We may save our lives. If we catch foes unawares, the first strike is ours.
There we go. What's that called? God's Throne Blossom? It's a interesting name for a flower. And then some Sunbright. Don't jump that way, please. So now just a matter of, I guess, working our way over to wherever that...
Must find another path.
Wherever that gargoyle is. Like down below somewhere-ish, I think. Forget, aha, there is a ladder. I was just going to say, I forget how, okay, don't do that, that would be bad. Forget how to get down there, but there's a ladder right here. And a spider. I haven't fought any of those in a while. God's Throne Blossom. Another chest. There is going to be some pretty good loot in here. As long as we can deal with all the harpies and whatnot. Alright, we're gonna work our way down over here. Bunch of more spiders. Which, really nasty creatures in real life, but in this game, spiders are not that bad. Spider venom. Okay, killed another one right there below the ledge. And now it looks like I think we're just going to end up sliding down off of this. Soulflayer Saurians. Ah, and those kind of bluish, purplish phantoms there? Those are phantasms, which we need a whole boatload of for our side quests. Cockatrice liquor, that's interesting. And then also Soulflayer Saurians all over the place here. That's okay. Soulflayer Saurians are nothing new. We have fought a lot of them on our way here. Now, those phantasms might be trouble. And I don't know exactly which elements are going to be useful against them. So, fire did a decent chunk of damage. Let's see what ice does. Nothing, because it's so slow. Alright, let's finish off that last Saurian there if we can. The problem with phantasms is just how long they can take the fight, because they can keep disappearing. Okay, and it looks like lightning doesn't do anything to them at all. That's unfortunate. So I guess I'm just going to stick with fire. There we go, killed one of them. Did it drop anything useful? Oh, nothing at all. Yeah, and Lucy and I are the only ones that can hit those things right now. The other two, my fighters, they cannot actually hit these phantoms. Oh, and I got drenched in water, so my lantern went out. Yeah, they can't hit it unless it's in the process of possessing somebody. Which doesn't look like it's going to happen anytime soon, because the way this thing is kind of dancing around. Yeah, can you possess me, please? Okay. Yeah, and Lucy has much, much, much better magics than I do. She has the advanced form of almost all of her spells. So, she's going to be doing a lot more damage than I am. Which is why her ice attack there just did so much. But, I can still kill it. Let's see what it drops.
Take care, you aren't soaked in water!
Astrocyte shard. And then when it died, it kind of exploded there, doing that little shock thing that knocked me over. That's what that was. Okie dokie. Yeah, so for a place named Soulflayer Canyon, this place doesn't actually seem to be so bad. And then there are ores and things that we can mine in here, so I'm going to do a little bit of that. Just because there's a bunch of new stuff here that we haven't seen, presumably. Copper ore. Please give me something better. Nope.
Even in numbers, a weakling is a weakling still.
I'm gonna grab some mushrooms, kinda let my party deal with those hobgoblins there. They're just hobgoblins. Shouldn't be that much of an issue.
Their kind is weak to fire.
I am at your side.
There we go, that lightning attack was very effective. Iron blade piece. What's in the chest there? Free spoken earring. That'll prevent the silence status effect, I guess. Or I would assume. Copper stone! Okay, so that's new. Hooray! Something new! That's always exciting when that happens. Sorrow stone, also new. Okay, so that's two new ores. And a crate full of potions to my left there. Looks like Lucy's gonna go pick up a bunch of those. And a rock.
I'll take that.
Arsbud sauce, bottle paste, throat drop, spicy mushroom tea. All just general curative items that will cure various status effects. Imperial acid? That's interesting. Don't know we've encountered too many of those. Mithridate. Lucy's gonna do a bit of mining there. Maybe? Oh, and another phantasm. Ooh, two phantasms. Yeah, the little lightning blast attacks they can do that stun us, those are just irritating. As is the fact that sometimes you can't hit them when they're flying around doing all their stupid little ghosty nonsense. Yeah, I don't think these are super dangerous. I think they're more just tedious and irritating to fight than anything else. But if Lucy can actually... Oh, see, and then Lucy's spells take so long to charge up that by the time she's about ready to use them... Kind of the same problem I have. The phantasms flying through them, attacking us, knocking us over, making us stagger, preventing us from casting our spells. There's one down, and it dropped something. Another astrocyte shard, that's good. There we go, we wrecked that one. And then, yeah, there's another one right there. Ooh, an actual piece of astrocyte. Like a whole piece. What is that? There it is. Cool. Don't really know what astrocyte is, or why we might want it. It's presumably going to be used to upgrade weapons or armor, that sort of thing. And we finished one of our two quests for killing phantasms. Yep, gargoyle time.
Everyone,
I'll heal all our wounded.
And I don't necessarily know what magic's gonna be more effective or less effective, although it looks like that lightning knocked him out of the sky without too much trouble. And I'm just kinda trying to keep it down with my light and quick attacks until Lucy can hit it with a meteor shower like that. Petrificator? Something like that? We got some piece of loot for killing that thing. It's exciting. Getting some more armor, picking some more herbs. I'm very heavily encumbered now. I'm not going to deal with my inventory just yet. White orchid. Nice. Lots of herbs. Lots of variety in the plants here, which is good. And now, I don't know if that was the actual gargoyle that we needed to kill, or if there's going to be, like, another one or something. Argents, that is a very rare cloth material. Giant coin pouch, 10,000 coins, that's exciting. Yeah, it looks like we need to go up-ish. We need to get up there, I think. So let's see if we can find a way to do that. Port Flat, back to Arsmith. What quest is that? A lost cause. Oh, acquire a snakeskin purse. Somebody picked up a snakeskin purse. That's interesting. I don't really think I want to go that way. Somebody saw a snow harpy. I don't think I want to go that way because it's on the wrong side of the canyon. I want to get up from here, from this side. Let's see if we can find a way to do that. Not through here. Maybe I do need to go on that side? I don't know. No, it looks like there might be a ladder or something here. There's a ladder symbol on the map. Herm. I used to know my way around this area. Not any longer, I don't. We came from over there. I don't want to keep going that way. Alright, we're going to go ahead and cross over here anyway. And just kind of see where we end up. If nothing else, we can continue to explore this area and just kind of get a better feel for it. Let's eat some saurian tails, because those are unbelievably heavy. Oh, and a harpy. Oops, wrong attack.
Insolence.
Don't want to hit that with an ice attack. That seems backwards to me. Cool, and a glacial pinion. That's exciting. Those are fairly difficult to come by.
There's a way up here.
So there's a ladder. We could go up there. As my pawns noted, we could also go down over there. Either of those is the direction I want. Back there, do we need to be up? Okay, I think maybe I do need to go back. Ooh, I heard somebody mining. That's exciting. Okay, I am going to end the video here, and we will continue exploring Soulflayer Canyon and try to find the note that we're after in the next video. So thank you for joining me, everybody, and I will see you next time.